Huh. How about that? Okay. What up, though? Roddy Rod, Big Business. It is 7 in the morning, 7 a.m. Eastern Time. Last night, your boy Abel dropped a 6-track EP, man. I swear, every time. I was literally, last month, listening to Star Wars. Just, you know, listen to it. Like, it's fucking amazing. Here we go again, man. With another one. 6-track EP. I'm cool with that, because most likely all 6 tracks going to be fire. So that's cool with me, man. And it's cool with me to do my reactions too, because it's going to be quick and easy. I get my ass in this bed because I've been working all night. So without further ado, track one, Call Out My Name, The Weeknd, My Dear Melancholy EP. Let's go. Let's go, man. This guy's voice. Look, man. You don't know what to expect with each track. I'm pretty sure like each track is gonna be 6 different styles throughout these 6 tracks. Too easy right now, man. What? Yep, it's hot. Oh, yeah. I'm not gonna lie, usually it takes a couple of listens for most of the Weeknd songs to grow on me, you know, really grow on me. Not this one though, this is hot. But lately, man, I've just been really just into dude music, so I'm just ready for this one. And see, that's what it is, man. Y'all don't understand, a true songwriter, vocalist, artist, all that, man. Ain't no looping this shit. Dude be doing the chorus over every time differently, man. Like, every time, there's always something in his songs that just, a part of it that just pops out for me, you know? Like, he might just say this one note different on the third chorus, and that's my favorite part of the song. Like, it just is, man. Like, anyway, man, let me chill out. That's track one, right? That's 5 stars. Track two, Try Me. I bet it's probably a whole different feel. Let's go. Maybe not. Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. It's nothing to him, B. It's nothing. Damn. You don't give a fuck, dog. Stop. Woo! Could you imagine trying to put together a top 10 weekend songs? I'm just saying. I'm not gonna lie, this reminds me of Kissland, which I really love. It might be my favorite. I don't know, Starboy was that shit. But I feel like Kissland really just blew my mind. And this song kind of reminds me of Kissland. Like the album, you know, the Kissland, like a song that would be on Kissland. Yeah, man, he still ain't shit, man. He still talk. Trying to get old girl to cheat on her man or whatever's going on. I mean, she's probably doing it, but he's not pushing her back. So, hey, but that shit was lit. I like that song even more than the first one. That's more upbeat, more my style. Let's get into number 3, man. Wasted Times. Ooh, the whole shit changed up. Facts. Woo. Nasty, man. It's just nasty. I'm borderline pissed that he didn't bring that chorus back. That's just... Hey, man, look. As I dig into some of these new age R&B artists, alright, given the benefit of the doubt, I guess you can consider Weeknd more of a pop singer, pop artist, and R&B, because he's definitely, everybody knows he's been heavily influenced by Michael Jackson, right? So, I mean, I guess you give him that, but goddamn, though, some of these R&B singers, these singers, man, that they rap, they try to rap more than they actually try to sing. Like, it's kind of like, what's really going on? And then you got this guy who's pretty much, what you picture music is supposed to sound like. No, like with the futuristic sounds that he puts into his stuff, but he still got the fucking voice. He still does so much experimental stuff with his voice and his music. This is what you kind of picture R&B would sound like nowadays. And you got some of this shit going around, which I do like some of it, but for the most part, it's like, I like hip hop, I like rap, so of course I would like some of this R&B because that's what they trying to go for. But this shit, this guy, we halfway through this. Y'all hear me though? Track 4, I Was Never There. Be honest, I kind of clicked on this one at work when I saw. Cause I got notifications like on his YouTube, like, song, the fuck? So I clicked on one. I heard about 5 seconds of this, and it was already bananas. So I Was Never There featuring I Will Never Get That Name Right. Guess a Philstein? Whatever. Let's go. It's your fault for having a confusing name. Woo! 5 stars already. Let's go. Ooh. Ooh. Bro, I'm dying. I'm dying on this one. It's the best beat so far, in my opinion. Shit. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and say it, man. Y'all know how I am, though. I gotta be critical with this shit. This the type of track you put first. Like, this how you open up the album with that. Look, listen. I mean, it's an EP, so it's not an album, but this, you open a project up with shit like this. It's kind of like a fire alarm going off, right? You know, like, that shit about to, it's about to get hot right now. Like, hey, anyway, let's get back into it, man. That's just me being me. Woo! Uh-oh. Alright, that's it. Five stars. What do you want to say? Five stars. Should be the album opener. I might be a jackass and just rearrange this track list while I put it on my iPod, but hey. Anyway, track five, Hurt You. We four so far. I mean, at this point, it's like, even if the other two I don't really fuck with, I'm good with these four. Four out of six. It's kind of reminds me of I Feel It Coming. Hey. Okay, this is a single. This is a single. Woo! Could you imagine being a singer listening to this shit? Like, come on, man. Take it easy. Like, shit would piss me the fuck off, man. I gotta compete with this shit. And that's the thing. I was like, because he just dropped this out of nowhere. Dropped this boy out of nowhere, right? I'm like, okay, he probably just had six hot songs, but not an album. You know, so he didn't want to go through all this. He probably, first thing came to my mind, he probably couldn't come up with like a single, a radio song. So he's like, whatever, man. Just put it out. Let's make this money. Whatever. But this is a radio song. This should be like this. Yeah. This would be so heavy on the radio. It might still be. I don't know how you're working this out right now, but this is hot. Just let that ride. Let that ride. Jesus Christ. I love that sound too. That's the fucked up part. Ooh, that rewind sound, that be on that funky fresh. This is hot. That was a hot. That's a single. 5 out of 5. Let's get into the last track, really. It's. Look, man. What you want me to say? Dude got his style. Dude does what he does. It's too easy right now, dude. Like. He can't strike out right now, dude. This a closer. Nice. Red pills take the blues away. We on that shit. Still dropping Matrix references. He just freestyled this song. He just freestyled this whole song. It is what it is. Alright, man. I don't know what dude trying to do. That's hands down my least favorite song. Like, you know, it was just like, okay, what's too much to it? I mean, it's the shortest song, too. So maybe that has something to do with it. But, yeah. But it's a nice closer. My favorite song got to be off first listen. Waste of Time. Yeah, hold on. Yeah. Or Try Me. Yeah. Y'all, you already knew what this is, man. I really don't. I mean, it's only 6 tracks. It's weekend being weekend. It ain't no like I can't feel my face. Or I don't know, false alarm. Like, it's no like upbeat real pop song on this, so I understand maybe the New World Weekend fans that gravitate towards that don't have anything like that on this album. This is like vintage Weekend, like 6 tracks. It's so versatile, like, you know, the tracks are so different, but at the same time, the same, you know what I mean. Like, he's still Weekend being Weekend, but he's still doing different things with the track. That's how you make a project, man. That's how you make a project. He just came out of nowhere. Drop it. It wasn't even 12, like 10 p.m. I just got to work. I'm like, God damn, dude. But I'm here now. It's already downloaded. It's already on iTunes, man. Cop this bitch. It's $6, all right? It's going on iPod. Thank you. Personally, I don't know. I mean, in my personal opinion, Bruno Mars, like, the only one that could drop, that could do this, just drop a quick EP, and I'd be like, yep, that's me as far as pop singers go, like, yep. So, only competition, but at the same time, he's in a different lane than the Weeknd, like, they're in different lanes at the same time, so, you know, can't really compare them. But they're like the only 2 singers out right now that I can think of that I'm like, let's go. Wherever you drop, boy, I'm there. And the fact that the Weeknd dropped Starboy, which is 18 tracks of fire. I gotta put him in the lead. And then you have this, which is 6 tracks. Bruno Mars, that album was only 9 tracks, so I mean, shit. Yeah, man. Yeah. Shit fire. Let me know what y'all think about this, man. Like, comment, subscribe, and share, all that. Big business. Ha ha, I'm going to bed. And it's a good Friday, so it is officially my weekend. Ha ha.